Hey there everyone, welcome back to the, I think this is the third part now of the TLR 8IGHT-XTE build series for Horizon Insider. We actually were graced with a beautiful day here in November, oddly enough, in Illinois, and I figured this was a perfect time to bring this out to the track and see what this thing can do. Now this is brand new still, as you can see it has not touched the ground, and I think that's the best part is I'm going to go out here, see how the kit setup works, and then we'll do a recap at the end. I'll talk about maybe some things that I changed, things that I liked, or maybe it's perfect. But hopefully you enjoy this and stay tuned till the end. Okay, so we are back after about an hour of running the 8IGHT-XTE, and it's really good, guys. The back is way more planted than I thought it was going to be. You know, my older nitro truggy, it's super aggressive. This thing is actually really easy to drive. It's really planted. It's almost too planted for my driving style. The one thing I did have to do was actually increase my servo throw. So I think, as I mentioned, I put a Spektrum 6280, I believe it is, into this. I actually had to turn up the steering to 125% with this particular Ackerman setting. So keep that in mind. Make sure you're getting full throw with whatever servo you like to run in your kit. And then once I actually achieve full servo throw, I probably need to change either my roll center or my Ackerman itself. The steering feels a little, it's not really in the track like I'm used to, so I'll probably play with that. But other than that, I mean, I could show up to a big race with this right now and enter the heats. I'd be fine. So that's really positive from a truck that's basically the kit setup. And remember, we put that Firma sensorless ESC and motor in this, and I honestly, honest to God, forgot that I had a sensorless motor ESC system in this. So I don't know. Spektrum Firma technology is really good stuff. I know a lot of us racer diehards would never drive something without a sensor wire, but I honestly forgot. So great stuff, great setup. Again, click the link in the description to learn more about the kit itself, and I'll put some info on the actual smart tech that's in here. Also, if you didn't watch the unboxing buying guide and then the actual build summary, make sure you do that as well. Other than that, I think we're done with this build series. Unless, I don't know, maybe in the springtime I revitalize it. But we'll let you guys go. Thanks for tuning in. It's Horizon Insider, and we'll see you in the next one. Thanks.